Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all are fine, doing good. Yes? Okay. So, are you all ready for today's grammar class? A short revision of where we had ended last time. Yes. Now class, let me ask you all, who is ready? Who can answer me what we had done last? Yes. Who will tell me? Yes. Neha, can you tell me what did we do last? Yes, we had done adjectives. Yes, adjectives. Now you all know adjectives are describing words. Yes, when we want to describe somebody, like there is a boy, but he is a tall boy, he is a short boy, she's a beautiful girl. So, the words like tall, short, beautiful are describing the person. Today, we go a little further in our adjectives. Yes? And there is comparison of adjectives. Yes, the chapter is comparison of adjectives. Fine. Now, I have got something to show you. What are these in my hand? What are these? Yes. You all know, very simple, they are spoons. Yes, what are they? They are spoons. Spoon, how is it? A spoon, big spoon. But when I show this, this is a bigger spoon. Yes, compared to this spoon, this is a bigger spoon. And when I bring this spoon in front of you all, you can see this is the biggest. Big, bigger and biggest. Yes. Okay, let's see further. Here we go. There are two comparison degrees of adjectives. As we saw just now itself, yes children, what we saw, there were two. We compared the spoons. First of all, whatever is in front of you, there is a cat. How is the cat? It is big enough, big cat. But when a dog comes, the dog is bigger than the cat. And when there's an elephant, it is the biggest. Yes, the elephant is biggest among these three. Yes, is it getting little interesting and clear? I can't hear yes or no. Please reply. Okay, good. Yes, right? Chalo, let's see the next one. Okay, now we have two girls in front of us. That is Radha and Mary. Radha and Mary. Radha is 1.5 meters tall. Mary is 1.20 meters tall. Who is taller? That is, Radha is taller than Mary. Yes, same we had seen with the chairs. Yes, there are two chairs in front of us. One is a chair and one is a stool. Now we see the cost of the two. The chair cost 250 rupees and the stool cost 130 rupees. Now when we compare both of them, we come to know that the chair is 250, means it is costly, and the stool cost 130 rupees. That means the stool is cheaper. It is less price compared to the chair. This is how we can compare between people, persons, animal, things, whatever is in with us. When there are more than one, we can compare. Comparison will always take place when we are comparing between two or more. Right? Huh? Fine. When to use and how to compare this. The use of ER. When we have the word tall and we add. When we have the word tall and we add ER to it, it becomes taller. When we have cheap and we add ER to it, it becomes cheaper. Old, older, etc. We can take all such words and we can compare them by using ER, right? By the use of ER. To compare two persons, animals or things. Yes, comparison will be between any two or more. Now, but there are certain words in our language where we cannot insert or we cannot use er. For in place of er, we are using more. Sometimes we use more. We say more beautiful, more interesting, more expensive, etc. Yes, we cannot use beautifuler. It's not going to sound proper and it's not correct. Okay, is it clear? Is it getting a little bit clear? Yes, are you able to understand? Yes, good. Okay, now once we have two people or two animals, we are comparing it with er word or more word. But when you are having some more than two, yes, maybe three, maybe four, then when you have to compare, you go to one step further, and that is when you are going to add est, right? For example, there are three statues in front of us. First is of Christ the Redeemer. What is the height of the statue, children? What is the height? How tall is the statue? It is 39.6 meters, right? Then we have statue of Liberty. Yes, you all know, na? Have you seen it in pictures or have you come across this statue? It is very, very famous. The statue of Unity. It is a very tall statue with 93 meters. But recently in our country, we have one more, the tallest statue of the world, and that is Statue of Unity. Yes, have you all visited Statue of Unity? It's very beautiful. It's worth visiting. Okay, so this is Statue of Unity. Yes, of our great leader Sardar Patel. And its height is 182 meters. So, you can easily say out of these three statues, Statue of Unity is the tallest. It is the tallest. Means comparing out of these three, what is in front of you, Statue of Unity is the tallest. So, there is no other statue as tall as Statue of Unity. So, we use the word tallest. We used EST, that is a EST form when you are comparing between like tallest, oldest, cheapest, etc. To compare three or more person, animals or things. As we understood earlier, when we are comparing, we had three spoons. So, we went to big, bigger and biggest. Like that. Understood? Is it clear, children? But one more word is there which we are going to use when we are comparing between more than two. Okay, that is we sometimes use most. We sometimes use most. Most beautiful, most interesting, most expensive. Now, you all as children, yes, you all might be watching lot of cartoons, animated serials and all which are coming in the TV. In the television. But when you talk amongst yourself, I watch this one, I watch that one. But you know, the most interesting cartoon is Doraemon. That is what you all might be talking. Yes? So you want to express that this is the best one. So we use the word most. Yes? There are so many temples in Bhavnagar. We stay in which city, children? In Bhavnagar. There are so many temples, but Takteshwar temple is the most beautiful. Yes, that is how we can make the use of most when you are comparing between more than two. And you want to show that something is best out of so many things. Yes, yes, children. So, now I hope the chapter is clear to you. Please revise it at home. Thank you.